Good day. This is April 19th, 2024. This is Minister Edward J. Robin. For people that are being influenced by land use bylaw. And I thought maybe it would be appropriate to give a little people a basic understanding of what's going on. The World Economic Forum, headed up by Klaus Schwab, has announced years ago that their plan is to take over people's lands and hijack them right out from underneath them, so they don't own them and claim that they can't grow their own food, they can't have more than a certain number of animals, they can't have people over after hours. Oh yeah, it's getting pretty serious, folks. So the provisions of 180 of the Criminal Code, a very important notation in your defense, not that you're gonna use it, but you can point them to it pretty much like, you know, a pup that's peeing or crapping on the floor and some people stick their nose in it. Well, pretty soon after a while, the pup catches on. Oh, I shouldn't be doing this here. So the same thing when you put a bylaw officer or a city council member under the knowledge of 180 of the Criminal Code, and that what is common to all of Her Majesty's subjects, it's what's in that King James Bible. And one of the things that's common is freedom, dominion over the land. That'd be Genesis 1:26. So while all of this is taking place, you originally had a contract with your county, your municipality, wherever you registered, there was a contract in place. Now, everything was going fine. You were willing to submit and pay taxes. But when they started getting nuts with this land use bylaw stuff and trying to take over your land, well, then the contract's frustrated because now they're interfering with you doing what is common to all of Her Majesty's subjects. They're making you feel uncomfortable. And by doing so, they've committed a criminal offense. If you read 180 of the Criminal Code, those people that are smart enough to go and actually type it in, and I do say smart enough because there's a lot of people, they'll just sit in stunned awareness thinking, okay, he's going to show me how it's all done, and they'll never go read it. Well, I don't know what I can do for people like that, expecting somebody to come and pass them the toilet paper and then they pass it back and say, will you wipe too, please? No. You have to go and read and learn. So 180 of the Criminal Code was put there in place by Queen Victoria to go along with 180 and 423 of the Criminal Code. And if you, again, read those sections of the Criminal Code, you'll see why they're put there to defend what is common to all of Her Majesty's subjects. Namely, dominion over the land. You get the right to raise up anything on that property you wish to. Vancouver versus Purchill, page 5, I believe it is, will tell you that. 1932 Supreme Court ruling over Vancouver and the roads. But there's a bit of dessert in there with regards to page 5 when it says municipality has no authority over the municipal landowner. He has absolute control over his land, and the municipality doesn't tell him what to do. Now, as it turns out, the municipality is a person of law. It's a dead legal fiction. Dead legal fiction. Look that up in British Columbia versus Stofan, 2001 British Columbia Supreme Court. Very interesting case. The judge blows it out of the bag as to what legal fiction is. So I thought I would give you a little bit of interest on that and information so that you can start to go and research your freedom to exercise authority over your land and put these persons of law on notice. You can no longer respect them, and that they don't get to come and intimidate you, 423 of the Criminal Code, from what's doing what's common to all of Her Majesty's subjects, following the Bible, namely God's gifted and granted dominion over the land, what you want to plant, what you need to build, whatever it is you need for your livelihood, as long as it's, now note this word, safe, safe, safe. Now, that means safe for you. So that means you're going to have to sign off the county there, the municipality, saying, hey, this is a disclaimer. You're not liable for anything that happens to me anymore. I don't need your policeman, big daddy, grandma, daddy in the sky, pepper routine. Take a hike. Because they're going to come on with land use enforcers for your water next. If they haven't done it already, they're coming for your water. And again, these three sections of the Criminal Code are extremely important. When you point them to the first article of the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, there's that typing and using your eyes and reading and thinking again. You read the first article on the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, and you see that it's there in the preamble of Canada's Emergencies Act. That means it's law in Canada. If you're not demanding accommodation for your wheelchair of faith, save your soul harmless. If you're not doing that, well, you're not going to get what the wheelchairs did. They got ramps. You're not going to get what the pedophiles did. They got access to the kindergarten children. You're not going to get access to your freedom of faith if you're not going to demand what the Sikhs did when they put the turban on the RCMP and they ride their helmets, I mean their motorcycles, without helmets. And there's many other examples of people that have gone to the extent of exercising their freedom in those areas that they're not to be discriminated against. If you're just sitting on your laurels figuring, oh, I'm a Romans 13 troglodyte, I got to do what Romans 13 says. That's not what Romans 13 says, sit on your butt and do nothing. No, it tells you that you're only supposed to submit to God's ministers of his temple, administering only his law and paying no taxes. You'll find that in Ezra 7, 23 through 26. So now you know how to read Romans 13 without having the wool pulled over your eyes, scamming you with, oh yeah, you got to go pay your taxes, render under Caesar. False interpretation. That's wrong. You don't have to listen to that when you got Ezra 7, 23 through 26 in the King James Bible looking at you, because it tells you who those ministers mentioned three times in Romans 13 are. All these council members of the day are thinking you're supposed to submit to their dead fictional government that's like a vampire upon your energies and your land. And so I hope you take advantage of reading these sections and asking your council members if they have the authority to ignore those sections of the law, get them on tape, and ask them if they recognize the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights and a demand for accommodation no different than wheelchairs or drag queens getting access to the kindergartens. Ask them that. Make sure you have them on tape when you see how they answer, because they can't discriminate against men and women of the faith in Christ in the King James Bible. Well, they're giving these concessions to people in drag queen outfits going into kindergartens to attack the moral standard, which is also common to all of Her Majesty's subjects. That moral standard is under attack. I wonder how many mothers and fathers complained about 180 of the criminal code because their comfort in doing what's common, exercising faith and beliefs, that defense of the faith is on guard and the moral standard is being protected. We're seeing it's not being protected, it's being attacked. Well, it's because people aren't going to their council members and asking them if they're going to recognize 180, 176, and 423 of the criminal code. Because if they're not, they're engaged in a conspiracy, 465 of the criminal code, to take away your freedoms, and that leads to a breach of trust and their fiduciary duty. So I hope that you take into mind that this is all upon a fake oath of allegiance that every minister that's acting in a provincial secular capacity has taken. All of the judges, all of the prosecutors, all of the lawyers, they all take fake oaths. You can go look that up in the Oaths of Allegiance Act inside the Oaths of Office Act of every province in Canada. Remember, when you find something comes along that you've been involved in, engaged in, registered with, and you find out it frustrates your faith, that's the Frustrated Contracts Act, and it's Amsalem versus Northcrest Syndicate, 2004. Supreme Court ruling. Amselem is A-M-S-E-L-E-M, 2004 Supreme Court ruling. And that was adjudicated that a contract cannot violate your ability to exercise your faith. Neither can it prevent you from taking up a faith. So it's very interesting to note that that coincides with the Frustrated Contracts Act in the respect of 176, 180, and 423 of the Criminal Code. So go get them. Now make sure your council members know about these sections of law. Bring it to their attention. Bring it also to their attention that they're being led astray by World Economic Forum troglodytes trying to take away from democracy and actually conspire to violate the criminal code. Remember, 465 is a conspiracy to take away those long-held freedoms of you had authority over your land, as you can see in the fifth page of Vancouver versus Birchill, 1932 Supreme Court ruling. The judge says the landowner has absolute use over his land and the municipality has no say over it. So please utilize that. There are many more tidbits like that in Diamonds in the Rough for people out there that are eager to find out how to become the master between the relationship of the servant of the council members and themselves as the ratepayers. I thank you so much for your time. May God bless.